Alright folks, so what we have here is one of the latest flashlights from Olight. It's the M2T Warrior Dual Switch Tactical Flashlight. It can run off of an 18650 lithium ion rechargeable battery or two RC123 lithium batteries. What I'd like to do is a review of this flashlight, take a look at how it's packaged when it ships, talk a little bit about its features and capabilities, and then get it outside for some beam shots. But before we do that, why don't you go grab yourself a nice cold one, come on back, and we'll get started. So before we get started, I did want to mention that I was contacted by Olight and they asked if I would do a review of this flashlight. And of course I agreed. I like flashlights, I like Olight products, and I like to do reviews. So they sent me this product free of charge in exchange for this video review. Let's go ahead and open it up and see what it ships with. It comes in a little bit different packaging than any other Olight product that I've seen. On the back of the package, there's some information about run times and different modes, and a reminder about the warranty, and then also they have this Q code. So there's the flashlight. Just upon quick inspection, you can see that this is a medium-sized to a large-medium flashlight. It has a pretty good traction plan. It's got some knurling on the tail cap. Let's go ahead and open this up and see what else is in the package. So we have a sheath, the flashlight, a user guide or instruction manual, and something that looks like a tip sheet. And this appears to be a tip sheet for the tail switch operation. So taking a look at the tail switch operation, momentary on is a soft press to the tail and it'll activate in turbo mode. Constant on is a deep press to the tail switch and a quick release. Momentary strobe is a deep switch and hold the switch to activate strobe mode. It says note, unscrewing the tail cap a half turn is recommended when the flashlight is stored or carried, transporting the light for a long period of time. They tell you that so it doesn't get turned on and kill your battery. Let's take a quick look at the sheath. So it's got a Velcro enclosure. It's got a hole at the top. I guess that's to let moisture out if any collects in there. It's got a hole at the bottom. Elastic siding. Inside the sheath is a typical neoprene Olight lanyard. Let's take a look at how it fits inside the sheath. Taking a look at the back of the sheath, you have a D-ring made out of some sort of plastic, and you can use this to clip to a belt or to a bag. Maybe a carabiner will work for you. And then it also has this Velcro loop here where you can run a belt through, or you can attach this to some Molly strapping. Let's take a look at this flashlight. It has a two-way pocket clip where you can mount this tip up or tip down. And it looks like you can take this off, and then you can put it down here, and then you can reverse carry. These are handy because you can clip them to a bill of a hat and then use this as a headlamp. The flashlight has a blue anodized crenulated bezel. A lot of people will call that a DNA collector. It has an orange peeled style reflector. The run times and specifications, which I'll include in the description below, have a number of different values and pieces of information, and this is depending upon the type of battery that you use. This flashlight can run off of two CR123A rechargeable lithium ion batteries, or it can run off of one 18650, which is what we're going to do for our light tests. We're going to take this flashlight outside in a little bit. We're going to do some beam shot tests, so you'll see how it performs. It's also impact resistance to 1.5 meters, IPX8 rated. It looks like it's 5.1 inches in length and 1 inch in diameter. And it weighs 3.53 ounces. Let's go ahead and open this flashlight up. Okay, upon opening the flashlight up, you'll see that it comes with two CR123 batteries. These are not rechargeables, and they come in this holster. I shouldn't call it a holster. They come in this container that allows you to fit them because they're a little bit smaller than an 18650. It's important to note on these batteries that they say do not recharge. They're not rechargeable. And they're at 3 volts. Now, earlier in this video, I mistakenly said that you could use rechargeable CR123 batteries. And I wouldn't do that because a rechargeable CR123 battery can be charged up to 4.1 volts, which gives you a combined rating of 8.2 volts. Two of these will only give you 6. I'm not sure the flashlight is rated to run off of 8 volts. For this video, because I want to get better output, I am going to use this battery from Olight. It's a 3.6 volt, 3500 milliamp hour, 18650 lithium ion rechargeable battery. Okay, now that we have the battery installed, let's go ahead and try this baby out. The first thing we're going to do is a quick press, and that goes to momentary turbo, and I probably just cooked the lens of my camera. Now I did a longer press, and what happens is that this goes on to constant on mode. Now I'm going to do a longer press and hold on, and there's a strobe mode. Using the side switch, I can also turn the flashlight on and off. And I can cycle through the various modes, the lowest being moonlight mode. So here we are doing a tire inspection. This is the flashlight on moonlight mode. It's not really bright enough. Here's a flashlight on low, which would be adequate for doing an inspection. Here it is on medium 2, medium 1, and high, which is super bright. It's probably going to wash out a little bit. And then just for fun, let's go to turbo mode. And when you turn the flashlight on and off, it does have a memory mode that takes you back to the last mode used. A long press from the side switch will take you into moonlight mode. Now remember, this is 1 lumen, so it's very dim. As mentioned, the flashlight will not do a tail stand. It does have some flat spots along the end of the head of the flashlight, and this is so it doesn't roll away in the event that you take off your pocket clip. One feature that I want to talk about is lockout mode. You get to lockout mode by taking the flashlight when it's off and holding it in. You'll first go to moonlight mode and then you'll go to lockout mode. When you're in lockout mode and you go to turn this off, the flashlight will show a red light on the side switch. It will also turn red if you attempt to use the tail switch at any time. Another long press will go back to moonlight mode and then you're back in normal operation. Let's go ahead and take a look at this map. And here we are in moonlight mode. And I can read this. If I definitely wanted privacy, this is how I would do that. If I didn't want to draw attention to myself, I'm going to go ahead and step it up to low. And that actually makes it reading the map a lot easier. I'm not sure how well that's coming across. Anything brighter than that starts to really wash it out and it reflects a lot of light back. And while I can still read the map, it's probably not preferable. The flashlight is quite comfortable in the hand. You can take the pocket clip off if it's more comfortable for you. This is a little bit of a larger, I would say a medium to large 18650 flashlight, but it fits in your pocket quite comfortably. All right, let's get this flashlight outside for some beam shots. So here's some video just walking around. I have the flashlight on low, step it up to medium 2, then medium 1. There's high. So you can see it really illuminates the area pretty well. There it is on turbo. Right here I am shooting the flashlight out at a little bit of distance on low, which is 15 lumens. When I step up to medium 2, I'm at 60 lumens. And this would be pretty good for walking around at night if you're walking the dog or taking the trash out. I step up to medium 1, which is 250 lumens, and that really illuminates the area. I have a lot of flood, but it has a really concentrated beam in the center, which you can kind of see. Step it up to high, which is 600 lumens. And then go to turbo, which is, went to strobe, there's turbo, which is 1200. Now this thing has a range of 195 meters. Okay, now I wanted to get a little bit of distance shot here on turbo. And you can see it lights up the area pretty well. Is it going 195 meters? I don't know, but I can get a pretty good range on it. Let's just go ahead and take a look at strobe. And as mentioned earlier in the video, the strobe on this one is 13 cycles per second. I really like this flashlight, and priced at $69, right under 70, I think it's a really good value. You have to keep in mind that it does not come with a battery, so you'll have to buy that if you don't already have one, and you'll have to pick up a means for charging the battery, like a battery charger. I've got plenty of videos on batteries and chargers, so if you want to check any of those out, go ahead, and if you have any questions, feel free to comment and ask. Overall, I'm really impressed with this flashlight, and I'm looking forward to using it as an EDC bag flashlight. I'll probably carry it around in my EDC backpack. Thanks for watching, everybody. I really appreciate it, and I appreciate Olight for sending this flashlight out for video review.